Welcome to the El Mirage Cooperative Management Area. This area is managed by the Bureau of Land Management for its unique recreation opportunities. My name is Cynthia Shervey, and I'm a geology intern at the Desert Discovery Center in Barstow. Today, we're going to explore a geologic formation in El Mirage that made this area a world-class recreation destination. Because of its unique flat surface, the El Mirage Dry Lake Bed is a focal point of the management area. Visitors enjoy photography, operating aircrafts, ATVs, and competitive land speed runs, just to name a few. So how'd this lake bed get here? That's the question I hope to answer today. So let's head out to the lake bed. During the Pleistocene-Holocene epoch, over 200,000 years ago, the Mojave Desert was a wetter environment due to the Ice Age. The elevation was around 2,860 feet, and the dry lake you see in front of you was actually a lake with a depth of 28 feet. The El Mirage Dry Lake Bed was formed due to the movement of two faults located nearby. The San Andreas, a right lateral strike slip fault, meaning the motion of the movement opposite from your position moves from left to right. The Garlock Fault, which is a left lateral strike slip fault, has the opposite movement. The combined movement from both faults has resulted in the land being stretched. This stretching has created a zone that is relatively flat and free of other features. With the ending of the last ice age and continued motion along fault lines, El Mirage was being influenced by the rain shadow effect. Moist air was being forced up over the San Gabriel Mountains where it would cool and lose moisture. The air on the downwind side of the mountain became dry, thus creating our desert environment. The area became increasingly drier and the lake began to dry up. Still remaining, however, was the alluvium in the lake bed. El Mirage Dry Lake was dominated by surface runoff and silt clay-sized sediments, especially from the Sheep Canyon alluvial fan of the San Gabriel Mountains. How did all this alluvium, also known as sediment, reach the dry lake bed? The steep San Gabriel Mountains, which have been battered by the San Andreas Fault and further eroded by wind and rain, sent sediment flowing down the mountain in stream channels. Once the sediment reaches the bottom of the mountain where it flattens onto the desert, the sediment spreads out into the shape of a fan, thus the name alluvial fan. Today, development in the San Gabriel Mountains and El Mirage area has diverted important sediment away from the lake bed, which helps replenish its hard surface. Driving and doing spins on the lake bed when it's wet or muddy breaks up the surface of the clay and creates huge ruts, which will take years to mend. For this reason, the lake bed is closed to vehicle travel when the lake bed is wet or muddy. Helping the BLM preserve the integrity of the El Mirage Dry Lake Bed by staying off it when it's wet and not breaking up the surface when it's dry will ensure its existence for the use and enjoyment of future generations.